Hello and welcome everyone. Today we shall discuss about the composition of bile and see which are the various reactions that bile gives. The composition of bile. Bile contains 96 to 98% water. In some places it's also written as 87% water. And the remaining percent is composed of solids. The solids include organic and inorganic constituents. Among the organic constituents are bile salts, bile pigments, cholesterol, fatty acids, lecithin and mucin. And among the inorganic substances are sodium, calcium, potassium, chloride, bicarbonate, sulfates and phosphates. We will begin with the various compositions. That is, its bile is made up of bile acids. Bile acids are synthesized in the liver from cholesterol and they are derived from the parent acid known as the cholinic acid. So first the cholinic acid is formed, and then from cholinic acid various other bile acids are formed. Now the next component of bile is bile salts. Bile salts are cholic acid, which on reacting with glycine gives glycocholic acid. And cholic acid on reacting with taurine gives taurocholic acid. Now both glycocholic acid and taurocholic acid on reacting with sodium and potassium form the sodium or potassium glycocholate and sodium or potassium taurocholate. So these two are the bile salts. Now the third component of bile is the bile pigments. The bile pigments are biliverdin and bilirubin, and these are formed from the breakdown of hemoglobin. They are excreted in bile and they have no physiological role. However, they have some clinical significance. Now, what are bile acids and how are they formed? Bile acids are formed from cholesterol in liver. First, primary bile acid is formed. The primary bile acids include cholic acid and quinodeoxycholic acid, and these are further processed by the intestinal bacteria, and after this they are converted to secondary bile acids. These include deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid. So there are around four bile acids. As you can see, the primary includes cholic and quinodeoxycholic acid, and the secondary bile includes deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid. The next question is, what are bile salts and how are they formed? So you can see here that cholesterol first gives rise to 7 alpha hydroxy cholesterol, from which after various reactions primary bile acids cholic acid and quinodeoxycholic acid are formed, and now these primary bile acids conjugate with glycine or taurine, whereas the secondary bile acids, that is deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid, they also conjugate with glycine and taurine and they form secondary bile salts. So there are primary bile salts and secondary bile salts. The primary bile salts include reaction between glycine or taurine reacting with cholic acid and quinodeoxycholic acid, and same way secondary bile salts, the glycine and taurine conjugate with deoxycholic acid and lithocholic acid. So these are the bile salts. Now, what are bile pigments and how are they transported? So after the red blood cell destruction or the heme protein catabolism, bilirubin is formed. Bilirubin is circulating freely along with albumin. So albumin is transporting bilirubin and it is brought to the liver. In the liver it undergoes conjugation, and this conjugated bilirubin is excreted along with bile into the intestine, and in the intestine this bilirubin is conjugated and with bacterial action it is converted to urobilin or stercobilin, and which is excreted in feces. A part of it however goes through the kidneys and the intrahepatic circulation, which is re-excreted, whereas the part that goes into the kidneys is excreted along with urine as urobilinogen. So as you can see, that bile pigments are formed from heme catabolism through various series of steps. The final product is bilirubin, which is transported with the help of albumin to the liver. Now, bile also has inorganic components, which include chloride, phosphate, and sulfate. So, what are the functions of bile? Bile is an important source of alkali, which helps to neutralize the acid, chyme from the stomach. Bile is an important channel for the excretion of some substances like bile pigments, many drugs, toxins, and various inorganic substances such as copper, zinc, and mercury. So it is extremely important for excretion of various fat-soluble components. Now, fat digestion is impaired in the absence of bile. The fat then converts the other food particles and prevents enzymes from attacking them or digesting them. So these undigested food particles ultimately lead to putrefaction in the large intestine. Now the presence of bile in the intestine helps in digestion and absorption of fats and the absorption of fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E, and K. We shall continue with bile. Bile salts act as emulsifying agents and they emulsify fat, increasing surface area and fats miscible with water. They activate pancreatic lipase and cholesterol esterase. They combine with free fatty acids and monoglycerides to form minute particles called micelles. These help in the absorption of intestine. They stimulate intestinal peristalsis. They stimulate bile production in the liver. They follow enterohepatic circulation and cause continuous secretion of bile by the liver. Cholesterol remains soluble in the gallbladder because of the presence of bile salts, and they aid in the absorption of fatty acids, cholesterol, carotene, fat-soluble vitamins D, E, and K by forming complexes more soluble in water. So, what is the clinical significance of bile? So, after knowing all the functions, let us look at the clinical significance. The bile salts are increased greatly in clinical obstructive jaundice. After prolonged obstruction, the concentration of bile salts in the blood may diminish due to diminished synthesis of these substances as a result of progressive hepatocellular damage. And in the absence of bile salts, gallstones are formed. So these are some of the clinical significance of bile. Now let us look at the physical characteristics. As bile is a body fluid, it is important to know what are the physical characteristics. So the pH of the bile is slightly alkaline. It is around 7.5, and we can determine the pH with the use of pH paper. The color of the bile is yellowish brown to green or orange. The odor is fishy. Transparency, it's clear, hazy, or turbid, and the specific gravity lies between 1.013 to 1.040. So these are the normal physical characteristics of bile. After having discussed the physical characteristics, now we shall look at the chemical characteristics. So the chemical characteristics include the organic constituents of bile. So we'll first see the reactions of organic constituents of bile. Now the first is the test for bile salt, which is the Hayes sulfur flower test. The principle is that bile salts are sodium taurocholate and glycocholate. They are emulsifying agents and they reduce the surface tension of water, and because of this the sulfur flower will sink into the solution. So now this sulfur flour is basically a sulfur powder, and it has a tendency to float on water. But if there is presence of bile in the sample or bile salts in the sample, then this powder may sink. So let us see what is the procedure. we take 2 5 ml tubes here. You can see 2 5 ml. I have taken 3 tubes here. This is the just to see the appearance of bile. The second tube consists of water and the third tube also consists of bile. So now in each tube we will add a pinch of sulfur powder from here with the help of spatula, and we'll see what happens to this sulfur powder. So what do you see here? That the tube which contains water or which has no bile, the sulfur powder is floating, whereas the tube which contains bile salts, the sulfur powder is sinking down at the bottom. So this indicates that the bile salts are present. So sulfur flower will sink at the bottom of the tube having bile salt solution, and whereas in the tube, second tube which contains water, the sulfur flower or powder will float on the surface. So this is a characteristic test for bile salts. Now the second test is the Pettenkofer's test, and the principle is that furfurils are formed by reaction of sugar with concentrated acid. These react with bile salts to form a purple red colored complex. The deep purple color develops at the junction of two acids and it indicates the presence of bile salts. So this is how the test is done. This is your sample to which you will add sucrose and concentrated H2SO4 through the side, and at the junction of the two liquids there will be a purple ring formed. Now the second now we begin with the test for bile pigments. So the first test that we will do is the Mellin's test, and the principle of Mellin's test is that bile pigments are oxidized to give different colors. So how do we do the test? We take 1 ml of, sorry about the background noise. Now we take 1 ml of concentrated nitric acid in a test tube, and then we add slowly 1 ml of solution, and we see different shades of colors over here. It can be pink or violet or red as seen here between the junction, and this indicates the presence of bile. Now the next test is the methylene blue test. This is also performed for bile pigments. Methylene blue, the principle is that methylene blue is reduced and the bile pigments are oxidized. So how do we do that test? We take 1 ml of bile solution, and to it we add 1 drop of methylene blue. So this is the bile solution, and to it we have added 1 drop of methylene blue, and it turns into parrot green colored, and this parrot green color indicates the presence of bile pigment. If we add too much of methylene blue, which is a very dark stain, then you may see not be able to see this color. So you have to be very careful while performing the test. You just have to add 1 drop to the side of this test tube, which will gradually slide down and react to form this green color. Now the next test is the Vandenberg's test. It is also known as the diazo test, and the principle is that azo bilirubin complex is formed, which is pinkish in color. So how do we do the test? Let us see the procedure. We'll take a tube having 1 ml of bile, and to it we will add few drops of freshly prepared diazo reagent, and we will see that a pink color is formed. The moment this pink color is formed, you know that the solution contains bile pigments. Now these same tests you can also do for abnormal urine if it contains bile salts and bile pigments. In continuation with the test for bile pigments, the next test is the Fouchet's test. Let us look at the principle. Bilirubin is oxidized to biliverdin by ferric chloride present in the Fouchet's reagent. This brings a change in the color of the precipitate from yellowish to greenish blue on the filter paper. So what you have to do is you have to take 5 ml of solution, and to it you add 2 ml of 10% barium chloride, and then filter it. You take a filter paper, place it in a funnel and filter it, and whatever is remaining, the filtrate that is on the precipitate on the filter paper, to that you add Fouchet's reagent. Okay, so now once you've filtered it, and now whatever precipitate is remaining on the filter paper, you add a drop of Fouchet's reagent to that. This Fouchet's reagent consists of ferric chloride and trichloroacetic acid. Now the bile pigments are oxidized to mesobilicyanin and mesobiliverdin. Mesobilicyanin is blue in color and mesobiliverdin is green in color. So if these colors appear on the filter paper on adding Fouchet's reagent, it will indicate the presence of bile pigments. So this is how we do the Fouchet's test. So there are basically three tests we see for bile pigments on this slide, that is methylene blue test, Vandenberg's test and Fouchet's test. Now the chemical characteristics, the next part is the inorganic constituents of bile. So the test for inorganic constituents includes the phosphate test, in which the principle states that inorganic phosphate is liberated when the compounds containing organic phosphates are heated with NaOH, and this inorganic phosphate reacts with ammonium molybdate to form ammonium phosphomolybdate, which is yellow in color. So what do we do? How do we perform? We take 1 ml of bile plus 5 drops of concentrated nitric acid and 1 ml of ammonium molybdate, and we heat it. Inorganic phosphate is liberated when the compounds containing organic phosphates are heated, and we get a yellow precipitate. So let us see. So you can see that this is the bile solution, this is nitric acid, and this is ammonium molybdate. The procedure I have already explained to you in the previous slide. Now we will just show you the two tubes, one tube before the test and one tube after the test. So after adding all the reagents, we will heat, and on heating we'll see some change in color, and this is how it changes. You can see that this is a solution of bile, and now on reacting with ammonium molybdate in presence of nitric acid, it is giving yellow precipitates, and this is known indicates the presence of phosphate. Now the next test is the chloride test, where the principle is formation of white precipitate due to production of silver chloride, which indicates the presence of chloride. And for this we need to take 2 ml of bile, and to which we add 2 drops of concentrated nitric acid and 1 ml of silver nitrate solution. Now in acidic medium, the silver nitrate reacts with chloride to form silver chloride, and when the silver chloride is formed, it forms white precipitate, and it indicates the presence of chloride. So we'll see a short video that has been recorded for you. So this is the video I was talking about. Now here also we have kept the bile sample, and this is nitric acid and this is silver nitrate. So you can take a closer look at bile, look at the physical appearance of bile. This is concentrated nitric acid, so you have to be very careful while using it, and this is silver nitrate, which is kept in a dropping bottle. So now you will see the two tubes. I'll show you. Now this tube contains bile, and I'll show you another tube which has in which the complete reaction has already occurred, and there is white precipitate which indicates the presence of chloride. Now this is the third test for inorganic constituents, which is the sulfate test. The principle of sulfate test says that there is a formation of right precipitate due to production of barium sulfate. So it indicates the presence of sulfate. So let us see the procedure. We take 2 ml of bile in a test tube, and to it we add 2 drops of concentrated nitric acid. And then we add 1 ml of barium chloride. Now on adding 1 ml of barium chloride, there is white precipitate of barium sulfate is formed, and this white precipitate indicates the presence of sulfate. So let us see the video. Now this is the video. Again here, first I've kept a sample of bile and all the reagents that are going to be used. I'm sorry, it is concentrated HCl that will be used, not nitric acid. So barium chloride is also here. Now I'll show you the 2 tubes. One tube will have bile, whereas the next tube will be bile reacting with these 2 reagents. So this is the tube with bile solution. And after carrying out the reaction, you can see the white precipitates of sulfate have formed. So this indicates the presence of sulfate. So at the end of this practical, now it's time for conclusion. We can conclude by saying that the organic constituents found in the given sample of bile are bile salts, which are the sodium and potassium salts of taurocholate and glycocholate, and bile pigments, which are bilirubin and biliverdin. The inorganic constituents found in the given sample of bile include chlorides, sulfates and phosphates. Now finally we come to the questions. What are bile salts and how are they formed? And what are bile pigments and how are they formed and transported, which we have already discussed in the beginning. So I'm sure you'll be able to answer the questions. So thank you very much for watching. Do complete your journals. Thank you for watching. Make your notes and complete your journals.